Today's lesson is recursive and explicit formulas for arithmetic sequences. A recursive formula is a formula that is used to determine the next term of a sequence from the preceding term. In an explicit formula, the nth term is expressed in terms of n, where n is a positive integer. Example, write a rule for the sequence 2, 5, 8, 11, and so on. First, as a recursive formula, and then as an explicit formula. Then find the seventh term. Solution. The sequence is 2, 5, 8, and 11, and so on. Represent the first term by A sub 1. The second term by A sub 2. The third term by A sub 3. And the fourth term by A sub 4. 2 is the first term, and it is represented by A sub 1. Notice that 5 is equals to 2 plus 3. But 5 is equals to A sub 2. So we can replace 5 by A sub 2 is equals to 2 is A sub 1. So we can replace 2 by A sub 1. So A sub 2 is equal to A sub 1 plus 3. Notice that 8 is equals to 5 plus 3. So 8 is 5 plus 3. 8 is represented by A sub 3. So we can replace 8 by A sub 3. And 5 is represented by A sub 2. So we can replace 5 by A sub 2. So A sub 3 is equals to A sub 2 plus 3. 11 is 8 plus 3. But 11 is represented by A sub 4 and 8 by A sub 3. So we can replace 11 by A sub 4 and 8 by A sub 3. So A sub 4 is equals to A sub 3 plus 3. The subscript 3 here is 1 less than 4. Now, if we replace 4 by n, then 3 is n minus 1. This subscript 2 is 1 less than 3. So, if we replace this by n, this is n minus 1. If we replace 1 by n minus 1, then this is n. Or if we replace this by n, then this is n minus 1. So the recursive formula is A sub n is equals to A sub n minus 1 plus 3, where A sub 1 is equals to 2. We are still solving the same problem. This time, we are going to find the seventh term. Solution. Using the recursive formula, A sub n is equal to a sub n minus 1 plus 3, where a sub 1 is equal to 2. Now, a recursive formula is a formula that is used to determine the next term of a sequence from the preceding term. So, using this recursive formula, we cannot determine the seventh term knowing only the first four terms of the sequence. We need the term preceding the seventh term. So we need to solve for the fifth term first, and then the sixth term before we can solve for the seventh term. So a sub n is equals to a sub n minus 1 plus 3. N is 5, and then this is 5 minus 1. So a sub 5 is equals to a sub 4 plus 3. But what is the a sub 4? A sub 4 is the fourth term. 1, 2, 3, 4. So 11 plus 3. So a sub 5 is equal to 14. The sixth term. A sub n is equals to a sub n minus 1 plus 3. So n is 6, and then 6 minus 1 is 5. So we have a sub 6 is equals to a sub 5 plus 3. Now a sub 5 is the fifth term. We know it already is 14. So replace a sub 5 by 14. So 14 plus 3 is 17. We can now solve for the seventh term. The preceding term is the sixth term. So a sub n is equals to a sub n minus 1 plus 3. Replace n by 7, and then this is 7 minus 1. So we have a sub n is equals to a sub 6 plus 3. What is a sub 6? It is 17. So replace a sub 6 by 17. 17 plus 3 is 20. So the seventh term is 20. We are still solving the same problem. This time, we are going to write the rule for the arithmetic sequence 2, 5, 8, 11, and so on as an explicit formula. And then we'll find the seventh term. Solution. The first term of the arithmetic sequence is 2. The second term is 5. The third term is 8. The fourth term is 11. Let us represent these positions of the terms by n and the terms by a sub n. When n is 1, a sub n is 2. When n is 2, a sub n is 5. When n is 3, a sub n is 8. When n is 4, a sub n is 11. Let us observe the values of n and the values of a sub n. Notice that the value of a sub n is equal to 3 times the value of n minus 1 times 3 minus 1, 2. 2 times 3 minus 1, 5. 3 times 3 minus 1, 8. 3 times 4 minus 1, 11. Let us show them below this one. 2 is equals to 3 times 1 minus 1. 5 is equals to 3 times 2 minus 1. 8 is equals to 3 times 3 minus 1. And 11 is equals to 3 times 4 minus 1. So our explicit formula is a sub n is equals to 3n minus 1. Using this explicit formula, we can find the seventh term even without knowing the preceding term. So if we replace the n by 7, we have a sub 7 is equals to 3 times 7 minus 1. 3 times 7 minus 1 is equal to 20. So the seventh term is 20.